Day number six, we're doing it. So exciting. Let's close your eyes and begin to turn inward as I open up to the guidance that I'm hearing that this particular audience is needing for this moment at this time, what guidance is necessary for us to realign with the highest version of who we are. Let's do three big breaths. Inhale and exhale. Another big breath in. And exhale. Another big breath in. And exhale. So clear. Acceptance. Yep. If we want to express ourselves, if we want to have courage, if we want to be authentic, we must step into this broader practice of accepting all parts of who we are. All right, let's go to the mat and see what's in store for us as we move and as we breathe. Let's take your hands to heart center. Acceptance. What does that feel like in every ounce of your being to be more open, to be more available to accepting all of who you are? Inhale, reach up. Exhale, pull it to the heart. Inhale, up. Exhale, right to the heart. So we begin with the heart. We begin with going back to that very powerful resonance center. Two more. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. I'm setting the intention that as we move and as we breathe, more than ever so before, we open up to realigning with the highest part of who we are that helps us really embody full acceptance. Accepting our light, accepting our dark, accepting all parts of who we are in the fullest, most vibrant way possible. Let's do one om. Take a big breath in. Om. Beautiful. Let's come to the top of your mat. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, flat back. And then exhale, stepping back, plank pose. Inhale, big breath in. And then exhale, setting this knee down, taking that foot flat to the earth, lifting up, opening up through the heart. What would you like to accept more of in yourself? Just identify right now. What is that? What would you like to welcome in right now in this moment? What would you like to accept in yourself more fully, more consciously right now? What is it that could have some more love around it? And just set that intention right now that today there's a miracle shift opening in the direction of you identifying what it is you want to love more, what it is you want to accept more, and taking into your practice and your awareness the ability and the real notion and the awake quality of bringing in more acceptance to that part of yourself. Good. One more big breath in. Nice. And then coming back, let's come into plank. Inhale and then exhale. Good. Enjoying downward facing dog, pedaling the feet. Nice. Taking your opposite knee down. I'm going to flip it around so you can see me, but you stay right where you are. You're going to take the opposite knee down and just opening it up. Same exact practice here. Bringing it back to the heart. So again, just you can choose something else now, or you can move into the same point of attention that you were bringing to when we did this on the other side. But our focus here is, what is it you'd like to accept about yourself? What does that feel like? How does it feel to move and to breathe as a being, as an entity that brings more love to that area? Open to it right now. Good. Nice. Two more. One more. Excellent. And then coming back to plank pose. And then back to downward facing dog. Let's inhale, lift up the left foot. and let it open up through the hip. Big breath in, and then exhale, lowering it back down. Inhale the right leg, opening up the front of the right hip. Inhale, big breath in, and then exhale, taking it down. Inhale, coming forward into plank. Exhale, moving forward, coming on down to your tummy, and then inhale, lifting up, rising up, interlacing your fingers back behind you to open up through the heart. You can shimmy back and forth here. What does it feel like to move in this pose, leading with the heart? Lift up through that heart. Open up through the front of that chest. Symbolically, metaphorically, and also practically, how does it feel in this pose and in your life to lead with your heart? Let your heart lead, guiding you to areas where you would like to accept more. Another big breath in, and then exhale, palms to the earth, moving back, downward facing dog. Inhale, left foot comes forward. Rise up, warrior one. Inhale, and then exhale, take your hands to your heart. Then move into warrior two. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, hands to your heart. Inhale, take your hand to your front thigh. And we're going to rise on up for one breath, coming into half moon, opening up through the heart here, extending up through that arm. Good, big breath in, and then exhale, coming back, warrior two. That's a challenging transition. They're wanting me to move a lot today because as we move, inhale one, hands to the heart. We have less time to kind of think. More time today, they're saying what's important, to breathe, to move, to be back in union with that non-thinking part of who we are. Look forward where you're going. Half moon is where we're going to end up. Lift up that back leg. Let's bring it to the heart. Inhale, reach up. Exhale to the heart. Inhale up. And then exhale back. Stepping back into warrior two. Good. Let's inhale, reach the arms up. And exhale, touch the floor. Inhale, reach up. Exhale through the heart, touching the floor. Inhale up. Exhale, touching the floor. Inhale up, touching the floor. Good. We're going to go up and then to the floor. Up and then to the floor. Up and then to the floor. One more. Up and then to the floor. We're going to face this way again, warrior one. Inhale, reach up, hands to the heart. Inhale up, hands to the heart. One more. Inhale up, hands to the heart, then open out. Inhale, hands to the heart. Inhale, exhale to the heart. Inhale and exhale. Now we know where we're going this time. So just take your hand to your heart, steady you maybe, and then your forearm, your left forearm to your left thigh. See where you're going and then rise up. Half moon. It might be easier this time because your body and your spirit know where we just went, so it's a bit more familiar. Let's do a couple to the heart here. Inhale, reach up. Exhale to the heart. Accept though, right? That where you are in this moment, what if it was perfect, right? What if it really was? Stepping back. That's what I see a lot. Just a little bit of the glitch in our programming is the part of us which consistently comes up and saying, well, things would be better if I just hadn't screwed it up, or if I was doing it better, or if, okay? Right. And here's the core and the beauty of that. The core and the beauty of that is at the center of that is the yearning for wanting to reconnect, to wanting to move back into source connection. And so when you see it as that, and when you lovingly place your hands around that part of yourself, and you say, I love and accept you, we might be out of alignment in this moment, in this day, in this week, in this year, in this lifetime, whatever, how long. But in this moment, it is here. It is coming forward because it's the opportunity for me to love and accept that part of myself, all of myself. That's what this is all about. All about. All about. Inhale, warrior one. Exhale, hands to the heart. Inhale, warrior one. Exhale, hands to the heart. Inhale, warrior two. Exhale, hands to the heart. Acceptance. Inhale, up. Exhale, acceptance. Good. Two more. Inhale. And exhale. One more. Inhale. And exhale. Right forearm to the right thigh. Looking forward. We're going into half moon. Reach it on up. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, take it back. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, bring it back. Good. Two more. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale. And exhale. Good. One more. And then coming back to center. Going side to side. Good. Very nice. Inhale, reach up. Exhale through the hands, through the heart. With the hands through the heart to the floor, rising up. Use that core, activate that core, reaching on up. Coming back down. One more. Beautiful. And then coming forward. Let's lift up through this leg, interlace the fingers underneath your hands, and then extend the foot forward. Coming back. And forward. And then back. I spent a lot of time on the earth. Can you tell? See any feet that are dirty here in this video? I am accepting all parts of who I am. Lowering that back down. And then lifting through the other side. Now, if you want to just take your hand to the wall, right, just go like this, steady it out. All good. If you interlace your fingers, you can really let yourself, let the energy of that thigh move into the earth. Oh, yeah, good. So every single time that someone in your life is pushing you, is pushing your buttons, is challenging you, is saying that you're an idiot, whatever it might be, whatever it is, what it is this instant. It's like this 911 call to your highest self saying, she's got to love. She's got to be more accepting of who she is. She's got to bring more compassion here. She has to move into that highest realm. She's got to do it. She's got to do it. And every single time it happens, it's the highest self working through you, bringing you this blessing to say, how are you going to respond? How are you going to respond? And that's what's so cool. When I talk to all these non-physical entities in my sessions, people that have passed, you know, in another parallel lying there, they're no longer in this physical realm of earth, and they say to me again and again, I see the times in which you are in alignment when no one else sees it. And it's so fun for me to celebrate that. So I just applaud you right now in this moment. I congratulate you for all the times that you could have, right, moved towards the dark, and the times in which you love and respected and honor the dark, and instead chose the light. And if you don't know what the light is in each moment, just take a beat, just take a breath, because it's your intuition that will guide you there. It is your heart that speaks the language of the intuition that will give you that clarity. So what is it you're confused about right now? Just identify something. There it is. And then right now, let's go to your heart and say, if I accepted myself more, how would that situation become more clear? Boom, I just got my answer. I put it out there, I went to my heart, I got it. If you didn't, that's okay. Let's try it again. We're just gonna warm up a little bit side to side. Think of something else or the same question. Where do you want more clarity? Where do you want more understanding? What's unclear? Choose something and then take a moment just in your breath. Set the intention, you're connecting into the highest good. And then just take a beat. Bring your hands to your heart. If I accepted myself more, what would become clear in this situation? Boom. And here's the thing, if that's foggy for you in the beginning, that's okay. It's a practice, just keep doing it. Just keep doing it. But we are in a time in which we are, again, moving from 3D to 4D density. What we need to do that, the skills that we need, one of the things that's gonna make it so much easier is if you take those beats and you just tune in and you just say, does this feel right? Okay, it's right then. Does this feel, no, it doesn't feel right. Then it's not right. It's that simple. As we become less dense, as we become more expanded, it's that instant, that instant guidance that we get, which is saying, how does it feel? And what is feeling? Feeling is vibration, it's tonality. That's all we are. And so we connect in and we just say, ah. And here's the cool part, as I'm recording this video, what my guides are saying, which I love, is that that's just gonna speed up, right? This might feel a little, maybe it isn't for you. And if it isn't, that's totally awesome. But we're gonna get to a point where we're not gonna have to go boom. You know, we're just gonna be in it. We're gonna be in the flow. We're gonna be so activated through our light bodies that it's just like, that feels good, I'm in it. That's just why it feels good. That doesn't feel good, so that's why I'm not in it. And we're just gonna stay there. How good is that? Let's shift onto this foot, lifting up this one. Let's reach it forward. Good, and hand to the heart. Inhale, reach up. Exhale. Inhale, again, do this at the wall if you want. The prenatal version of this, which I love, is right at the wall. So just take the wall and just lean into it. One more. Good. And then back to center, other side. You can bend that standing leg, spread through the toes. Inhale. Make the declaration today. You're going to practice accepting more of who you are. What do you have upcoming? What would it look like if you just accepted everything that you did was right on track? Even if your brain's going, it's not right on track, I messed up. Okay, all right, you messed up. Yet, even in the quote, messing up, it's the opportunity, which it is again and again and again, for you to love yourself. So how is anything really messing up? Okay, so we're out of alignment, we're off path, whatever. It's all, if you can take in that essence of everything being more neutral, right? Even good and bad, we have charges around it. But what if it was just good and bad? And what if from our, this is the way our highest self views our reality, which is it's way neutral because it sees good and bad. And that means all the people on this planet that are overwhelmed in bad, right? You know who they are. We send lots of love to them. And yet at the same moment, from the charge, from the perspective of our highest self, it's not, it really is a neutral experience. It really is a neutral perspective. Because why? Let's go up and down. Because the good and the bad are leading us towards spiritual expansion. So even the bad that's here, that's leading us towards more light, it just is what it is. When you take that spiritual perspective, you don't get caught up in the densities of what's happening right now. And you can laugh, which is really important. Because when you start seeing on your Facebook feed, or whatever, the news channel, and you're just like, wow, is that what's happening? Okay. Yet at the core of it, it's for my spiritual expansion, all of it. Even if it's just that is so disgusting and horrible and I hate every single ounce of what I'm seeing, why? Because it gives us the opportunity to love who we are. Okay, good. Let's move into triangle pose here. Let's take one block. Good. And let's just find our triangle. I have this beautiful opportunity where every night before we go to sleep, in my neighborhood, I can't find and identify, but there's a little dog who was left outside who's barking for about 3 to 4 hours. I've walked around, I've tried to find it. It's echoing, it's reverberating. It's a little weird for me to walk behind people's lawns. Anyway, point is, the reason why my guides are asking me to talk about this is because I'm lying there in bed and I'm sitting there going, why is this happening to me? Because I'm not the type of person that can just like, I'm just not the type of person that can be like, oh, well, you know, just cut it out. And I try to be that way, but I'm not. And so something like that, like it scars me through the center. And so why does it do that? And my highest self was saying, my guides were communicating and saying, it says because you have to move into the highest resonance. No one is praying for that dog right now. And so the last couple nights, what I've been doing is I just start praying for that dog. I communicate to that dog and I send that dog love. And I just move into that place of total love. And I just think I have two rescue dogs. And I put so much love and energy into them. And I start focusing on and accepting how much I am doing and how much I can contribute. Because why was that little dog bothering me? That little dog is an extension of myself. And it's the part of myself that still wants to be accepted. It's the part of myself that's left out in the dark, that's voice is hoarse and it's saying, attend to me, right? So in that moment, I said, okay, here's what I can do. I'm lying in bed and I just move into that space of love. And it doesn't necessarily take the pain away for me, but it sure does make it a heck of a lot easier. I'm also talking about this because as I bring into your awareness, your love is sent to that dog. And that makes me feel really good too. Now, why is that so important? Because you are becoming so aware of why you, okay, take a moment, do these guys up and down. Speaking of, my dog wants to go outside. I'll be right back. Can't remember where I was at. It will come. Let's take these fingers, interlacing, opening up through the heart, leaning on back, and just go side to side here. Use the core just to stretch it out. Stretch it out. Leaning from side to side. Acceptance. Let's just go side to side here, stretching it out. Good. Let's come down to the mat. Just make sure you can see me. Okay. Yeah, you can see me. I'm going to pull this back a little. So let's bring the soles of our feet together. I love Sundays because there's a holiness in the air. You just feel it. You feel a lot of people bringing their attention to that holiness. Ah, that's where we were. Beautiful. Very powerful point. And so what's amazing is that, as you know, there are entities in this reality that really get that perception is everything, right? And if you are not really... How do we word this? If you're activated or frustrated by that, right? What we want to do is we want to just see and understand what is the technique that they're actually doing to get what they want. And here's what it is. They really understand. They really get. And this is the part of you that really gets. And you understand this as well. And I'm speaking to this part of you that totally understands, and we're just turning the light switch back on, so this is not new information for you. This is just information that you're remembering. You remember that in every moment, the greatest power that you have is your perception. Even in the darkest of darkest, darkest moments, it's that ability for you to accept and to say, okay, in this moment, I have the ability and the power of my perspective to see how it is that I want to interpret this. So your highest self is expressing through you, and it's giving you these different opportunities to be challenged, to grow, to expand, to love, to accept. And it's the power of our perspective that helps us in the remembering of that to leverage and pull back into source. So what does that look like? That looks like you're in the depths of depression, and you're in the depths of a crappy day or a really hard problem, whatever it might be. It's that loving, beautiful, warm, accepting dialogue you have with yourself that says, okay, we're going to figure this out. We're going to get through this. This is how we're going to move forward. And we're going to move forward by loving and being as kind and as gentle and as accepting as possible. Now, that doesn't mean, here's the difference, which is really important. That doesn't mean that accept means like, right? So you might have some people in your life that you don't like. That's okay. we can still accept them. We can still accept that part of ourselves, that which we don't like. We can still bring love to it. It's different because I have people say to me a lot, well, I'm not going to accept this situation. I'm not going to accept this person. And what they're really saying is, don't make me like this person. That's fine. The beauty of our reality, you can keep in these arm movements if you want, or you can stay static over this leg, is that no one is hearing what's happening inside of your head. Nobody. So you can move through your day and be extending a lot of love and warmth and being real with yourself and saying, wow, I really don't like that person. And that's okay. It's okay. I came in here having preferences, having clear, strong opinions, and that's okay. Now, the tricky part is, if we don't figure out how to accept and to send love and to send compassion to all parts of ourselves, all beings on this planet, our energy gets a little blocked. That's it. So it's a technique that when we get into that perception and that understanding, and just giving yourself permission to go back to, I don't like that. It's freeing. It's liberating. Not liking things gets us really clear on what it is that we are to like and what it is that our guides and highest self are leading us in the direction of getting us to follow where we're meant to be. I love one of my teachers, what she would say to me, and I would come to her and I'd say, you know, I just feel like this is the way that I'm meant to go. But yet there was all these blocks and, you know, well, I shouldn't be doing this and this shouldn't be the time or this is going to be uprooting, you know, all these different things, of all these directions that I'm getting pulled in. And my teacher said to me, and I say this to you because this is where they're guiding me to go, is that when you're feeling that pull, that's because it's your guidance. And that's because it's your job and your calling, really, to move in the direction of being open and available to trust. There's that trust. That this is your pathway. That this is where you're meant to be. Good. Let's come forward. And let's just hang out here in a forward fold. My doggy now wants to come in. Forward fold, you can just let your head go and just let yourself really relax. Good. Folding forward and down. Nice. And let's come lying on your back. If you have two blocks, what I'd love to do is a heart opener here. One block goes this way, the other goes like that. This lands about right about here, four ribs up, more or less. My shoulder blades fall off it, and then this other one comes along the ridge of my head. I can extend my legs straight out, but let's just bring the hands back to the heart. I inhale, reach up. I exhale, bring it back to the heart. Inhale, reach up. Exhale back to the heart. You can also do this with a bolster. You can also just do fish. If you don't have blocks and you know fish pose, you can move into that. It's another beautiful heart opener. And just feel that heart open and expand. Feel the shoulders drip away. Let's do two big breaths here. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale and exhale. So if you're feeling, you know, off track as you move through your day or the rest of your life, go back to this theme. That's why my guides give me these themes, because they say to me, when we're off track, we need a a punch in of love. One word, get like boom, pull me back. And so the word for today is acceptance. Anything you're feeling off track in any way, think how it is that you can accept yourself and accept others.
Because here's the deeper part, right? Anything that anybody isn't accepting about you, or anything you're not accepting about somebody else, is what you're not accepting about yourself, right? Everything is this mirror. So if someone gets triggered by you, and they don't accept what you're doing, right? It's all about their perception, because that is, right? We're the driver in this driver's seat. We're the projector of our reality. And you guys know all this. This is not information for this particular group, they're telling me. But we just want to not only turn the light switch on, but we want to amp up the voltage on that. So there's more awareness, there's more consciousness, there's more integration on that particular notion. I am creating this. And this is where people get frustrated, saying, I created this horrible situation. No, it was your highest self pulling in this to your reality so that you could grow and expand. And that's why you hear people say, I'm doing a hip opener here, you can watch me as I do this. That's why you hear people say, wow, I got cancer and it was the best thing that ever happened to me, right? Why? Highest self presented cancer in this reality. You have the guides and love around you that were there and became available. The person rose, they expanded, they reunited with their highest self through this challenge. And then they thank cancer, which they should. They should, right? All of us. Or all of us in that place of gratitude can just do circles with the legs here. So I have one block under my sacrum, one underneath my head, and I'm just doing some freeform with the legs. Good. Let's take the soles of the feet to the earth, and let's just do one bridge pose. Inhale, lift up, and then exhale. You can interlace the fingers underneath you. Excuse me. Lift on up through the hips. And then let's exhale, coming on down. Let's bring the soles of the feet in towards the chest. So now we're completely flat on our back. Let's inhale, lift the legs up. Exhale, take our hands underneath our booty. Let's just do some lifts here. So we're protecting our low back. We're just lifting up and down. Let's do 10 of these. 10. 9. Acceptance. Keep committing to it. Again and again. 8. Keep committing to the understanding that understanding and identifying what you don't like is bringing you closer to the pathway of what you do like. Okay, I'm going to speed this up. Let's just do 2 more. 2 and 1. And we'll do just little lifts here. Little teeny lifts. I'm working on my lower abdominal wall. And I'm just lifting up and down. Little pulses. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. We'll stop. 10. Lowering the feet down. And just letting yourself rock the knees side to side. Stretching out through the abdominals and the low back. And now just intuit and see, is there anything that you need in your physical form? If not, you can move right to Shavasana. If you would like to do anything else right now, please go for it. I'm going to start moving to our cards and seeing specifically what messages we have for us today. Here's the law of attraction, everyone. I think this is the only card in my deck which has the word accept. And it's our first card. So nice job, everyone, because we pulled coyote, which I love, which is, it's really about accepting all parts of who you are. So pretty obvious. Thank you, everyone. But what they're saying is that this session in particular, you know, they're all going to resonate with us, but they're showing me 3 individuals. This is going to be very life-changing. That's really cool. Meaning that something really clicked for some people here where they're going to move forward. And even in the darkness, even in the light, there's just going to be a greater connectivity, a greater connection to the technique of acceptance.
So spiritual practices and techniques are really designed to give us the tools so that when we're on the spiritual path, which is the path of awakening and expansion, and, you know, maybe that sounds, you know, really lovely. My experience is, though, that it's intense. It's intense when you really say, I want to stay awake here. It's intense. And we need tools, we need tips to help us get through it more awake, more alive, more expanded, more raw in this reality, which is seeing things as they really are. Second assignment for us, very specific assignment, is the hummingbird and joy. And really just giving ourselves permission today to do something really fun. So whatever that might be for yourself, let yourself have fun today. Get it in. Third card is about dreams and just paying attention to your dreams and vision. It's the lizard. And so what they're saying today is that before you go to sleep, if you still have challenges or you have areas that you want to accept but you're having blocks about, I really want to accept this about myself or this other person or this other situation or this other dynamic or this timeline, I want to move into another timeline where I get it, where I'm accepting it, where it's not that I like it, but I'm accepting that I don't like it and I'm okay with that and my tonality feels more easy and peaceful around that. Before you dream, write it in your journal. I'm setting the intention, guides, entities, everyone here loving and guiding me, that as I go to sleep, I open up to clearing these pathways to feel the experiences through dreams, through traveling, wherever I'm going to go, that I align with this experience of the solution and I embody the solution. That's when you wake up sometimes and you've been knocked out and you get up and you're like, oh, that's what I need to do. Here's why. Because at night, you travel to that version of yourself, you sunk up with it, you set the intention before you went to sleep, and then you align with it in sleep time, and then you woke up in this reality and said, oh, of course. That's why, if you don't know, sleep, meditation, these things where you go back in, you have these pathways connecting back in with all this beautiful non-physical information of the highest good. You pull it in, it integrates, you get up refreshed. So important. That's why when people are tortured, they take away sleep. So just putting that in as well, my guides are saying that the folks here could benefit from more restful sleep. So making sure that your haven of rest is a sanctuary, that there are no electronics happening, there is no Wi-Fi nearby, you turn it down, that there is no whatever, that you have beautiful dark out shades, that you have sheets that you love, that you have everything. Here's another thing too, it's interesting. One of my clients told me once she had a feng shui person come in and she actually had too many books in her bedroom, which is fascinating because they were saying that your being can't really relax because it's kind of around all this intellectual knowledge and it's trying to take it all. So you just want to make sure that the sleeping area is a total sanctuary for yourself. So as you rest, as you relax and let go completely, let's start deepening the breath. Reach your arms up, stretch up into greater acceptance, wiggling the fingers and the toes. Roll on over to one side, and before you press up, realize you're realigning in this moment already with a version of yourself that's more accepting of who you are, of every aspect of this world. Press yourself up to sit. Take your hands to heart center. Let's close with an om. Take a big breath in. I'm setting the intention that as we move forward into our day, we accept and accept and accept more fully, more vibrantly, more completely, and that gets us into greater connection with love, greater feeling of kindness, and overall more experiences of joy and peace. Namaste. Thank you so much for spending this time with me. Thank you. Please like and subscribe and spread the word. We have momentum going here, and I'm so honored and delighted you're with me, getting me on my mat. It's such a privilege to breathe and to move with you. So thank you. Namaste, and have a glorious day.